Hello, Gunner fans. This is Brian92, and today I'll be looking at the SD cross silhouette Shin Getter from. It was in the Neo Getter versus Shin Getter OVA and the Shin Getter Armageddon OVA. And I got the model kit from Canadian Gundam. Link is in the description below. So, this is the second SD kit of the Shin Getter that I have. The first one was a D style. And this is pretty good. It does have solid green instead of clear green, like the other one. Although it does have a lot of stickers they want you to put on for the panel lining to show like getter rays, which I didn't put on because I think it just kind of ruins the look. And also you'd have to especially the rounded areas, you'd have to keep putting the making sure the stickers are back on because they'll start to peel up eventually, and I just don't want to deal with that. I just use the ones on the eyes. And I think that's enough, really. You got a lot of color on it. It looks pretty good. I like the two-tone red. That's nice. The silver for the arms, which it's weird. They sandwich between the red, and you think it'd be a good fit, but I find it's very easy to see like that. I move that a little bit, and it's separated. So not as good as I thought. You might want to glue the two halves of the arms together. Now, articulation-wise, you do have the ball-jointed head with the hinged neck. Can't go very far back because of the backpack. We got the arms that can hinge forward and back, and they are ball-jointed. We also have an extra hinge to go out. And then you have a swivel at the wrist, or sorry, at the elbow, a ball-jointed wrist. You do have a ball-jointed torso. You've got the hinge in the hips so they can come forward. Then you have a rotation in the knee, I guess it is, kind of, and the ball jointed ankle. So it is very limited in this form because this is the SD mode. And you do get the wings for the getter wing. Very thin and bat-like. You could probably put them in maybe without taking the backpack off, but I don't want to take that risk by breaking them by accident. And they are ball jointed, so you can get a little bit of movement there. You also have a pair of open hands, so you could pretend to do the Stoner Sunshine attack. Just gotta get a clear effect piece. The arm blades are already coming apart. That's really annoying. But you got that. And you also have the getter tomahawk, which is super big, very long. But it definitely looks good. I mean, it's accurate to the OVA, especially the Shin Getter Armageddon, where it was super exaggerated. I like it. It's a little hard to get on a shelf, so you have to have it probably like that. But it's okay. Now, of course, to make it into the cross silhouette form, just like the other Super Robot ones, you have the extra joints. Oh, you have a connector for an action base if you want to put on one. But you have the extra joints and the extra eyes. They give you another forehead piece too. And just like the other ones, it's very minor in the eyes. They're just a little thinner. It really wouldn't matter if you kept these ones on or not. But they tell you to switch them, so I'll do it. It's pretty easy. And then of course, swapping out the limbs. Now this one, you do have to replace the light. The light is new, only for the Shin Getter, as far as I know. But you do have to swap them out with the hinge for the elbow. And just like before, the smaller joins are for the arms. And the bigger ones are for the knees. That's a drastic difference. Because, like, you can barely see the light in the SD mode. But there is Shin Getter Robot in its cross-solid form. Much better. Looks a lot better. And now it does have the elbow hinge, which can still rotate, and the knee hinge, which can still rotate. And I do find you get a little more range in the hip because the red's not hitting it. You can get a little bit in and out. So definitely more articulation in this form, as it should be. Yeah, I'll just give it the tomahawk. Yeah, so I'll bring in the SD Cross Silhouette R72 and the Mazenkaiser. Mazenkaiser makes sense because this is like in the 90s where they were trying to like update the super robots. So you had like Mazenkaiser and then Shin Getter. And, were there other ones? I can't remember, but those are the ones I can really think of. I feel like it was the extreme, time. And finally, I mentioned it, the D-Style Shin Getter. Which, it's hard to say. I like them both. But, I like the fact that this one has clear green. But the, neon green really pops on the, new one. And of course it has the two-tone red, where this one doesn't. Initially, I thought I would like... I do like the wings on this, but this is more accurate, actually. The long, thinner ones. Especially in the one scene where the Shin Getter was fighting Getter Dragon. And like when it opened, the wings are really thin and far apart. So, I was going to say the D-Style is my favorite, but I think I like the Cross a little bit more. But they're both good. Aside from the arm separating, but that is like my one problem with the kit, is that these spike parts, is if you touch them, you're going to separate the arms, so you probably want to glue them, but everything else is really good. It is a good addition to the Cross Silhouette line. So if you want to pick it up, click the link below to go to Canadian Gundam, and I'll see you in the next review.